Hi, my name is Thomas Plunkett. This is part of my Understanding Crypto video series. I'm going to do a review of Bitcoin and Blockchain Security by Gassen Karami and Elian Druckenmiller. So this is a pretty good textbook. In fact, I think it's the best current Bitcoin security textbook that's available. It's got great information on potential attacks against Bitcoin. It's got a good discussion of confidentiality and privacy, and it also dives into wallet security and privacy. The book was published in 2016, but the security and privacy analysis is still accurate today in 2021. However, there has been some progress in the field since then, so a second edition would be very welcome. Here's a look at the table of contents for the textbook. Chapter one is just a high-level introduction. Chapter two gives us a background of digital payments, basically covering the history in the space before Bitcoin. Chapter three then explains what Bitcoin's solution is from a protocol perspective, describing the building blocks, cryptographic hash functions, Merkle trees, electric curve, digital signature algorithm, and so on. It dives into the Bitcoin data types, scripts, addresses, transactions, and blocks. Talks about the peer-to-peer network and the different node types, and then talks about some of the scalability measures in Bitcoin, request management systems, static timeouts, transaction advertisements, and the internal reputation management system. Chapter four covers security of transactions in Bitcoin, and really, I think chapter four is the most important chapter in the textbook, so I'm going to talk about that one last. So let's dive into chapter five then. Chapter five covers privacy in Bitcoin. It takes a look at user privacy, looks at privacy quantification. It talks about ways in which attackers can exploit Bitcoin clients to discover information about who's doing transactions. It talks about behavior-based analysis and coin tainting. It also looks at network layer attacks, how there can be privacy leakage over the Bitcoin network. And it takes a look at some of the different proposals for enhancing privacy in Bitcoin, things like mixing services, coin join, protocol enhancements, as well as Zcash and Zerocoin. Chapter six dives into wallets. What are the particular security and privacy issues of using a lightweight wallet, using simple payment verification, SPV? So first thing it does a detailed explanation of how SPV works. Then it talks about some of the security capabilities SPV has. And then it talks about privacy provisions for SPV, Bloom filters, leakage, privacy leakage due to the network layer, leakage due to how the Bloom filters work, and so on. Chapter 7, 8, 9 are really more high level chapters after we had these detailed chapters in 4, 5, and 6. So 7, 8, and 9 are really looking at some of the aspects around Bitcoin. 7 talks about Bitcoin's ecosystem, payment processors, exchanges, wallets, mining pools, and so on. Chapter 8 covers applications and extensions of Bitcoin. And really this is other cryptocurrencies, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Namecoin, digital assets. Chapter 9 talks about blockchain beyond Bitcoin. So it covers Ethereum and Ripple and some other blockchains. So really though, I think chapter 4 is the most important chapter of the textbook. And so here's a detailed look at chapter 4. Chapter 4 starts by going over security confirmed transactions. It explains how Bitcoin's transaction verification and confirmation works. Then it talks about some attacks, for example, Eclipse attacks in Bitcoin, as well as potential for a denial of service where you're denying the delivery of transactions. It also dives into selfish mining and insecurity for zero confirmation transactions. And finally, it talks about Helfini's double spending attack and then other approaches, attacks, for example, exploiting a Bitcoin fork to a double spend. So that's a detailed look at chapter 4. So all in all, I think this is a great textbook. If you're interested in understanding how Bitcoin's security model works, the book was published in 2016, so it would be nice to see a second edition because there has been advances since then. but the basics are pretty much the same, as Bitcoin has not changed a whole lot in the last 5 years. So thank you very much. I'm Thomas Plunkett, and this was my review of Bitcoin and blockchain security.